In this video, I will be showing you how to mod LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga step by step. Before you can use new characters, each part of this tutorial must be followed correctly, so make sure you do watch until the end of the video so you don't miss any of the details. Also, be sure to subscribe to my channel right now for more LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga mod videos. Due to the recent updates that have released for this game, the modding steps have changed a little bit, so this is why I'm making this updated tutorial. So let's get started. Firstly, you'll need a copy of LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga on PC. This does not work on Xbox, PlayStation or Switch, and never will. The second step is to install .NET 5 and 6. There are three links in the video description down below that you need to click on to download them. Every link you need for future steps in this tutorial are also found in the description as well. .NET 5 and 6 are required to run two things that allow you to mod the game, so you can't miss this step. When you've downloaded the three things, just follow the on-screen instructions to install them, and once they've been installed, go to the video description again and download the TT Games patch tool. This will stop the game from crashing when you load it up with mods. Once that has downloaded, extract it wherever you want. Next, you need to locate where the Skywalker Saga is installed on your PC. Find it by searching LEGO Star Wars Skywalker Saga _DX11 in File Explorer. It will find it and then right-click the application and open File Location. When you have both the game folder and patcher folder open, drag the game.exe onto the patcher. You'll likely see this windows pop up. Click More Info and run anyway. When you've run the patcher, you'll get this message saying it is a success. Press any key to continue. After that, head back to the video description and find the DAT Manager link. Just click on it, download it, and extract it. This is a latest version of an application I showed in my previous mod tutorial. It was made to work with the Capital Ships update and includes some major improvements. Inside the game folder, you can see a file called 002Core8Win64.dll. You need to copy that into the DAT Manager folder you've just extracted. When that's done, open the DAT Manager application. In this DAT Manager window, press File and then Open All DAT Archives. It will ask you to select a folder. Just choose the Skywalker Saga game folder. When that's chosen, press the Extract dropdown and set Extract Location. Again, make sure this is the Skywalker Saga game folder so you don't go losing those files. Press Extract once again and extract everything. Leave it alone to extract every file. How long it takes will depend on how fast your drive is. It took around 10 minutes on my Gen 3 NVMe. Once the extracting has completed, you need to move all of the game DAT and DLC DAT files out of the main Skywalker Saga folder. Personally, I made a folder inside the Steam Common folder titled Backups and DATs, so it's easy to find them. Drag the DATs out of the Skywalker Saga folder and into your chosen destination. If you don't do this, the game won't launch. Upon completing this step, your game is now ready and set up to install mods. You can play the game without mods in this state too, if you wish to do so. This is probably a good idea to make sure the game will open fine and you've not made any mistakes in a previous step along the way. Your game is now set up and ready to install mods. You can play the game without mods in this state if you wish to do so. This is a good idea to make sure the game will open fine if you've not made a mistake in any of the previous steps. The next step is to install the mods. The two websites you can use to download mods are Nexus Mods and Game Banana. You'll find links to these in the description below. Personally, I'd use Nexus Mods because the site is just better. Many people who have modded other Star Wars games know Nexus well already. Some modders only upload their mods to one of these sites, so I do recommend checking both of them still. When you've found the mod you want to use, download it and extract the folder. I will show you the most common way mods can be installed. Some mods have instructions on their page or README files included with them, because some mods do differ differently in how they install. But I will show you the most common way mods are installed and use a typical example, which is the Captain Rex mod. Plus, you'll also learn how to back up your files. I'd recommend making a backup folder, perhaps the same one that you use to place DATs in. As you can see here, that's what I did. You will place the original files of the game in here, because you will be replacing them. If you don't create a backup, you cannot uninstall mods until you've re-extracted the entire game again. If you don't care about this, you don't need to make a backup, but it will just save you a lot of time. You can see here that the Rex mod download includes the character folder, and inside there are more folders. What you need to do is follow the folders, such as the minifig folder, through to the files. You need to do this with the Skywalker Saga folders as well. It will be the same folders. Find the file in both folders and copy the one from the Skywalker Saga game folder into your backups. Then replace the Skywalker Saga game folder file with the mod file. Some modded files don't need to be replaced as they are new files. You will need to repeat this step for each file included with a mod. When all of those have been moved over, you can open the game as normal and play. Select the character that the mod replaced to view the modded characters. As you can see, the clone captain was replaced by Captain Rex. If you follow the instructions correctly in this video, you will be successful in modding LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga without any issues. If you do happen to have an issue and things don't work correctly, make sure you do all of the steps in this video correctly. It is tested to be working for everyone, so it will work. If you still have questions, comment them down below in the comments, and either myself or someone else will respond. If the Skywalker Saga gets a patch update in the future, you will have to delete the extracted folders and re-extract all of the DATs again. This is an issue people had following the Capital Ships update and following my previous tutorial. Also, if you want to know how to install scripthook mods, such as the character customizer, I made a video tutorial on that which you can watch by clicking the top right hand corner of the screen right now. Let me know in the comments below which mods you are now going to be installing thanks to this video. If you found this video helpful, drop a like to help others find this video too. Subscribe for more LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga videos, and if you missed any of my previous videos, click on the playlist on screen right now, and I shall see you in my next Skywalker Saga video. Goodbye.